In this problem, we're given information about the performance of a batch reactor for a particular reaction system. In particular, we're told that for this reaction of A going to B plus C, we achieve a conversion of 90% over the period of 1 hour. And we're going to use this information to determine what space-time is going to be needed in order to achieve that same conversion of 90% in a continuous stirred tank reactor. All right, we're going to go through a procedure whereby we go through three steps in order to set up the material balance for this system. We'll first do this for the batch reactor. And the strategy here is that although we're given some information on the batch reactor, we don't know all the parameters. So for example, we don't know the rate constant. We don't know the volume of the batch reactor. We don't know the concentration of the reactants initially in that batch reactor. All right, so some of these unknowns we might want to be able to solve for so that we can then use the values of those unknowns to determine what the performance in the CSTR would be. The three-step process begins with specifying a material balance. The form of that is dictated by the fact that we are starting with a batch reactor. And here for a constant volume batch reactor system, we can write that the batch time over the initial concentration is equal to the integral from a conversion of 0 to the conversion of 90% that's given in the problem of dx over negative Ra. All right, and that's the first step in our typical algorithm for solving reactor design problems. The second step is to express the reaction rate as a function of concentration. And here we're given the fact that this is a first order reaction, and so we expect the reaction rate to depend on the concentration of A to the first power. And so this gives us that the rate of consumption of A should be equal to some rate constant that's a function only of temperature times the concentration of the reactant. And now in the third step, we need to be able to integrate this equation. And so we should express this concentration of A in terms of conversion, since that concentration will decrease as conversion increases, and we need to express that. Now, this is a liquid phase reaction system, which means that the density isn't going to change appreciably with time. And it's also a batch system, so we're going to expect that the volume doesn't change with time. And therefore, the concentration of A is equal to the number of moles of A over the reactor volume, which is a constant. All right, and that's equal to the number of moles of A that we start with minus the number of moles of A that are converted through reaction. That's how much we're left with. If we factor out the initial number of moles of A, Na naught, from this equation, then we'll get an Na naught over V, which is equal to Ca naught times 1 minus X, which we can then plug in for the concentration of A here in order to get the following. Now, if we look at the two sides of our equation, we realize we have a concentration of A in the denominator on both sides of our equation. We know the batch time is 1 hour, and so therefore, if we can solve the integral dx over 1 minus x integrated from 0 to 0.9, then we can solve for the value of k, because again, k depends only on temperature. We can say that the batch time is equal to 1 over k, which we can pull outside of the integral. The batch time, again, is going to be 1 hour. And then we can do this integral. And integrating the expression dx over 1 minus x from the limits from 0 to 0.9 is just going to give us the natural log of 1 over 1 minus 0.9. T is equal to 1 hour, and so now we can just solve for the reaction rate constant K. And we find that it's equal to 2.3 reciprocal hours. Now we're going to try to use the value of the rate constant in order to solve for the space-time that's needed to get 90% conversion in a CSTR. We'll again follow the same three steps. So first is the material balance for a CSTR. And we'll write that the volume of the CSTR divided by the inlet molar flow rate of component A to the CSTR can be re-expressed as the volume divided by the inlet concentration times the inlet volumetric flow rate. And this V over V naught is just the space time divided by Ca naught. And according to our design equation for a CSTR, that's equal to the conversion divided by the reaction rate at the final conversion in the reactor. All right, so that's the first step. The next is, again, expressing the rate as a function of concentration. All right, this is still a first-order reaction system, and so we can write that This is equal to X over KCA. And then finally, we want to express the concentration of A in terms of X. And that also has the same form as in the first part of the problem. So we get a KCA naught times 1 minus X. All right, and the reason it follows the same form is that we have a constant density system, all right, where because it's a liquid phase system, the change in the number of moles during the reaction doesn't matter. And so we expect that the concentration of A will just depend in this simple way on conversion. All right, now that we've applied all of these three steps, we can check on what our unknowns are. And so again, we want to solve for tau in this case, and we can use this relation to do so. And so we can cancel out these values of CA naught, just as we did above. We still know that we want to achieve 90% conversion. So X is still equal to 0.90 for both of these values of X. And then the rate constant we solved for in the first part of the problem is equal to 2.3 reciprocal hours. And therefore, we're able to solve for the final space time. And we find that it's equal to 3.9 hours. So in other words, we need in a stirred tank to achieve this conversion of 90%, we need 3.9 times as long when we're running this process continuously as we did in the batch reaction system. And this again is because batch type reactor systems inherently for positive order reactions are more efficient. And that's because the rate is equal to K times the concentration of A. In a batch reactor system, this concentration of A starts at the initial concentration, and so the rate is relatively high at that initial condition. And the reaction proceeds until you achieve the final conversion, at which point the concentration of A is at its lowest value. All right, and so you take advantage of the fact that for all of the reaction time up until you achieve a 90% conversion, and therefore rates that are higher than at the final conditions. All right, in contrast, for a CSTR, that concentration is the outlet concentration of A. So the entire tank contents are always at the outlet concentration of our reactant, which is the concentration at 90% conversion, and therefore the lowest possible value for the concentration. And for that reason, the rate on average is a lot lower in a CSTR than in a batch reactor. And so we need more space time than we do batch time in order to complete this reaction.